And welcome to the Bring It On Again Network. And tonight's big story is about cheerleading injuries, particularly concussions. Sally, haven't you had multiple concussions?
I don't remember.
Oh. Okay. What do you have for us?
We have Kitty Carr standing by live at Cheerio's cheerleading competition in California with Dr. Jones.
Kitty Carr reporting live at the Cheerio's cheerleading competition. Popularity of cheerleading has significantly increased over the years, resulting in more risky stunts being performed by the athletes. This has led cheerleading to become the second highest risk of concussions among these athletes. With us today is Dr. Jones to provide more information on this injury. So Dr. Jones, what exactly is a concussion and how is it caused?
Well, Ms. Carr, can I call you Kitty?
Yes, you may.
All right, great. Basically, what a concussion is a disturbance in brain function, and it's caused by a traumatic blow to the head or body. And so what happens is the brain rapidly accelerates forward, smashing into the front of the skull, and then decelerates backwards, smashing into the back of the skull. And as a result, the brain cells become disturbed, which causes an impairment in mental function for a short period of time.
Okay. Wow, that's very interesting. Mm-hmm. And how long does the average concussion last?
The majority of concussions last around 7 to 10 days, but for children and adolescents, it may take a little bit longer.
Okay, well, thank you very much for the information, Dr. Jones. Shall we get back to the cheerleading?
Absolutely.
I'm here with Coach Monty to hear how she prevents her team from getting injuries. So Coach, we saw that horrible fall. What do you do to prevent your athletes from having injuries like concussions?
Right, well, as we saw before, you know, that was a really nasty fall. But cheerleading involves, it's very physically demanding. So to make sure that my athletes are in tip-top shape, I make sure that they have components of fitness such as strength, cardiovascular, core, proprioception, those kind of things, which actually does help prevent injuries a lot. So I make sure my players are in these kind of conditions in order to prevent injuries such as the concussions that we just see.
Okay, perfect. Do you think you'd be able to demo some of those exercises that you do?
Absolutely.
Okay, thanks. Let's go.
All right.
Then I spent so many nights thinking how you did me wrong, and I grew strong, and I learned how to get along, and saw your back from out of space. I just walked in to find you here with that sad look upon your face.
have to do a lot to make sure they're in shape to participate in the sport. Is there anything else you need to do as a coach to make sure these individuals have to participate?
Well, it's really important. A lot of responsibility is on us coaches to make sure that our athletes can properly catch, fall, and bail out of any maneuver that we expect them to do. So it's really important that we have proper teaching skills and we know what we're doing in terms of feeding this information back to our athletes.
Okay, well, thank you very much for your time.
Thank you.
And now we're going to do a brief video on the return to play guidelines. I hope you all learned something about concussions and the prevention of this injury. I'm going to now send it back to Sally and Aggie. This is the Bring It On Again Network, and I am Kitty Carr.
That was a really nasty
fall.
Horrible.
Yeah,
I hope she's okay.
I don't
know what you mean. Well, that's all the time we have for tonight, folks.
Be sure to catch us tomorrow at 6 in Mondaire, Alberta, with the world's biggest sausage.
Hope they have a big bun for that. Have a good evening. We'll see you again tomorrow.